love you too, Mom. Good night.
Friend of mine, and when my life is over, remember when we were together. We were alone and I was singing a song for you.
Go behind enemy lines with military maneuvers, undercover agents, and the final series of Wish Me Luck.
We're obviously building up activity in all areas in anticipation of the invasions.
The case, open it. What have we here?
Nobody's going to die.
It's not dangerous work.
Something big's going to happen.
Things are going to hot up here very soon.
British agents and the resistance prepare for battle. A new series of Wish Me Luck begins next Sunday, 7:15 on HTV.
The Sony TR-55 is a revolutionary new camcorder with power zoom, autofocus, a recording capacity of up to 3 hours, and hi-fi sound. But you can't see what's most revolutionary about it until you put it in the hands of an adult. The Sony TR-55. The smallest camcorder in the world.
I work to keep my body in condition. Keeping my hair in condition shouldn't be so hard. I may need a conditioner, but I don't need the hassle. I want to just wash and go. I've got all I need, right here. It's new Vidal Sassoon Wash and Go. It's shampoo plus complete conditioner in one bottle. My hair's clean, feels good, and it does what I want it to. My hair looks great, and all I do is wash and go.
New Vidal Sassoon Wash and Go. Shampoo plus complete conditioner.
Call on the Fast Print Professionals. 24 exposure films developed into top quality prints for only £2.99. Fast Print, branches throughout West Wales.
Don't miss the famous John David sale with great savings on fine furniture. The John David sale is now on at Market Street, Hoylake, Wirral.
Again, Terry Griffiths clears the table. His best break ever, his new Uptake Kitchen. Uptake Kitchens and Bedrooms, Cardiff and Swansea.
The spotlight is on Slater's of Abergele for used cars. Selection, service, value. For guaranteed peace of mind, it's Slater's.
Everyone's going there.
The spectacular VFM sale is now on. Where?
Hyper Value.
Yes, at every one of the King of Cup price stores. Where else?
The Arthur L. Jenkins Furniture Sale is now on. Our furniture centre at Gorsinon is packed with outstanding winter bargains you can't afford to miss. Lounge, dining and bedroom suites, carpets and rugs, We've savings throughout the store on famous brand names, and there's free delivery throughout Wales.
Arthur Llewellyn Jenkins, where quality counts.
For furniture at its finest.
We're going to come and live here soon, Timmy.
Install a total heating system, and your home is suddenly a warm and cozy place. Total heating means continuous, controllable warmth. A tank full of piping hot water. And because it makes the most of less than half-price electricity, total heating is economical to run.
What have you been up to?
It's gonna be nice here, Mum.
Not central heating. Total heating.
The new season on HTV. A wealth of new faces and some more familiar. Taggart returns with another murder to solve in Hostile Witness.
After 4 to 5 hours, she was taken out and mutilated.
She must have been kept in something.
In El Cid, two CID detectives swap Scotland Yard for the Costa del crime.
Should have done this 20 years ago. This is paradise. Sun, sand, sex and sin. Strictly for non-cardiac cases. Get something before it's too late. Who's this to?
Don't know. Haven't made my mind up yet.
Patricia Routledge stars as amateur sleuth Hetty.
I'm Chief Detective Inspector Henry Wainthrop. This is a disguise buster, so hop it.
A new series set in a Brussels detective agency, Tex.
In England, he was just a scientist. What he did didn't matter. But here, everything's so public.
Chancer, when a business blazes, whiz kid Stephen Grain is called in to clean up.
Banks are banks, Gav. They just won't spend into a loser. This is unadulterated emotional blackmail, and I apologize, Stephen.
They're making news at TNC, the news channel.
What have you got today?
Prison riot in Sheffield.
Why didn't you have one yesterday?
I am an editor. I am not God Almighty.
But I am.
Internal conflict and worldwide turmoil. HTV's new season, Pure Magic.
It's New Year's Eve on HTV Cymru Wales. Good evening. Now with the time approaching 9:05, we join ITN for the latest world news.
The news from ITN.
New Panama government wants to charge Noriega with murder. Suspended ambulancemen say they'll be on standby for Trafalgar Square celebrations. Romania's new rulers warn against anarchy on the path to democracy. And Berliners say goodbye to the year that saw the wall come down. Good evening. The government of Panama is to charge the deposed dictator General Noriega with murder. Panama will ask the Vatican embassy, where Noriega has been hiding for a week, to hand him over so he can be charged over the deaths of 10 army officers. Diplomatic sources say the move could eventually lead to Noriega's extradition to the United States.
On this last day of the year, the U.S. Army have been trying to coax the last remaining Noriega loyalists out of hiding. They were competing with Panamanian citizens, trying their own appeal to the former dictator near the Vatican embassy. Others prayed for a solution, but some Catholics stayed away from mass today, angry that the church is sheltering Noriega. Their priests read out a letter from the country's bishops. It asks the Pope to hand the former dictator over for prosecution. President Indara took communion with his countrymen today and then stayed on to receive their blessings. I asked him how long he thought the deadlock would continue.
I hope that in the next few days will be the thing. He has no right to be there. He's a common criminal.
And what will you do with him? Will you hand him over to the Americans?
We have no possibility of giving him due process. We hope that the Americans get him before we do.
But there is confusion in the new government. The Attorney General saying today he wants Noriega handed over to him to face murder charges.
We will try anyone who commits a crime.
In the embassy garden today, they were still talking, still hoping to negotiate a way out. that would have to include a way past the American welcoming committee still lined up outside the gates.
The Vatican is still praying that Noriega will listen to their pleas and give himself up. But so far, there's no sign that Panama's most wanted man is about to do that. Ken Reese, ITN, Panama City.
The opposition leader, Neil Kinnock, is to meet President Gorbachev in Moscow on January the 16th. They'll discuss the changes taking place in Europe. In his televised New Year's speech, President Gorbachev has wished the countries of Eastern Europe success in their revolutionary renewal and said the dramatic events there prove the need to combine socialism with democracy. Romania's new president, Ion Iliescu, has warned that the country is so unstable it faces the risk of complete anarchy. The former head of the secret police has been arrested, but many agents remain at large. Today, the government gave details of how it intends to create a multi-party democracy.
Outside the television station, which now has enormous symbolic importance to the revolution, armoured personnel carriers and fresh troops were drafted in amid reports that remaining Securitate forces were planning renewed attacks over New Year's Eve. Inside, the arrest of a suspected Securitate agent did little to lessen this sense of unease in the waning hours of the year. You could measure the human cost of the revolution at Bucharest Cemetery. 10 days after the fighting, they were still burying the dead, with those left behind determined that their sacrifice will not have been in vain. And this afternoon, this gathering of academics and intellectuals met to ensure that these hard-won liberties were not squandered by the new government.
This is not a palace revolution. This is not a revolution which has taken place at the top. It has been a revolution of the people.
And the people, he said, were the true guardians of democracy. Captain Mikhail Lupoi gambled with his life when he went on live television to rally the troops in support of the people 10 days ago. He's a major now, and as he gathered with his wife and one-year-old son, he had bittersweet thoughts for the year ahead.
She's not sad or joy, but which is saying both things at the same time. So maybe at 12 o'clock we will sing for the dead people and for the people who will be born.
And for thousands of families across Romania who've survived this most turbulent moment in their country's troubled history, a time now to remember the terrible price they've had to pay for their freedom.
We're joining you live now from Studio 7 at Romanian Television, and you'd be pushed to find a more exhilarating place to see in the new year. There's no one with more cause for celebration tonight than these technicians, journalists and soldiers. They've lived in this building since the revolution. They've kept it open during those dangerous days over Christmas. And their prayers tonight will be for a happy, but more importantly, peaceful new year. Now back to London.
Further evidence is emerging daily of the luxury lifestyle enjoyed by Romania's former dictator Nicolae Ceaușescu. At his private hunting estate, deer were drugged to make easy targets for the late president.
It was Ceaușescu's favourite sport. So he passed a law forbidding anyone else to shoot them and then cordoned off 2,000 acres of the best hunting land for himself. He built this plush hunting lodge, but even his local caretaker was never allowed entry. This for him was the first glimpse inside. This is where Ceaușescu and his men would feast on their hunted meat. And even in this remote area, 500 miles from the capital, Ceaușescu wanted his political library with him. But it was the deer which brought the president here, and he was proud of his hunting achievements.
But hunting for Ceaușescu was made easy. First, an advance party of his men came and drugged the animals. Then they were taken to the edge of the forest to within yards of Ceaușescu's hunting stand. From there, all he had to do was look down and shoot them.
He'd kill hundreds of deer in an afternoon from this vantage point, but he never let the locals share the spoils. And in the nearest village, where the people queue for bread, there's seething resentment. This man said Ceaușescu's wealth made him sick, riches gained from a people enslaved. Ceaușescu may have fallen, his hypocrisy now exposed, but this winter revolution has still left Romania's poor queuing for tomorrow's food. Penny Marshal, ITN, Honosh.
The West German Chancellor, Helmut Kohl, has called on his countrymen to strive for a united Germany and a united Europe. He said the 1990s could be the happiest decade of the century. In Berlin, thousands of revelers from both East and West are holding joint New Year celebrations on what remains of the Berlin Wall.
Tonight in Berlin, the boundary between the two Germanies is becoming even more blurred. Here at the Berlin Wall, just by the Brandenburg Gate, the champagne is flowing. Everyone is so excited. Even the East German border guards on the wall have rather given up trying to maintain any sort of order. Down below, people pop backwards and forwards through the holes. And through another hole, another East German border guard takes advantage of the new liberties. After all, it is New Year's Eve. Anything goes tonight. Bits of the wall are still being chipped out as souvenirs. It's not easy. For the young, the sparklers are the attraction. They'll just know when they're much older that they were here for this historic moment. And tonight, the absolute minimum formality is here we are. We've just been waved through by the border police. No passports, no visas. We're standing here in what used to be one of the most closely patrolled and guarded areas of East Berlin. And just look at it now. The balloons are floating high, the bangs of fireworks. And below the magnificent monument, the biggest New Year Eve party in the world is underway. A bit of free enterprise here. Champagne, sausages, glühwein. This storekeeper's never had such a good day's business. And it's still early in the evening, as thousands are drawn to this spot. And still the people flow back and forward through the wall, breached as the last days of the 1980s shudder to a close. And as the fireworks burst high from west to east, they can look forward to a new decade full of uncertainties but rich in opportunities. Desmond Hamill, ITN, in East and West Berlin.
The cousin of Terry Waite, who's been held hostage in Beirut for nearly 3 years, has made a New Year's Eve appeal to his captors to release him. John Waite said the past year had brought a series of raised hopes followed by disappointment.
I think the key to this whole hostage situation with Terry and the other British hostages is relations with Iran. And I would hope very much that in 1990, the British government, which I'm sure wishes to have better relations, can get those good relations going with Iran, because Iran is the key. Once that is settled, I think the hostages will then be released.
Also held hostage with Terry Waite in Beirut are John McCarthy, Brian Keenan and Jack Mann. The ambulance unions have attacked the Health Secretary, Kenneth Clark, for describing most of them as no more than professional drivers. His comments came in a letter to a 15-year-old schoolgirl who wrote to him pleading for her ambulance man father to be given a bigger pay rise.
15-year-old Lisa Mitchell wrote to the Health Secretary pleading with him to increase the 6.5% pay offer to ambulance men. In her letter, she pointed out her father earned 50% less than a policeman of similar experience. Mr. Clark's reply to Lisa's letter has incensed Nottinghamshire ambulance men. In it, he said the vast majority of ambulance staff had no extended paramedical training, adding, they are professional drivers, a worthwhile job, but not an exceptional one.
He says that they're just professional drivers, which they are not. They go out there and they save lives. If it just takes a professional driver to get people to hospital, then they could just get in a taxi, on a bus, on a train and go to hospital. They're professional drivers.
Meanwhile, the London Ambulance Service faces its biggest test yet. 30 St John's ambulances will attend Trafalgar Square, where 60,000 are expected to see the new year in. To minimise trouble, police officers will be stationed on all approach roads, preventing those that are obviously drunk and disorderly from getting in. Three suspended ambulance crews will also be working without pay. They deny their action is a publicity stunt.
I'm sure you'll find that we'll be used this evening. As I say, we provided emergency cover from day one, and we will continue to provide emergency cover.
Around midnight, the London Control Centre will be fielding 300 calls an hour. They'll be dealt with by just 90 police and army vehicles.
Will you use the three London Ambulance Service ambulances if you need to?
Of course I will. If any LAS ambulances appear at Trafalgar Square, as I hear through the media, they're likely to, providing they report their availability to our emergency control unit, which is controlling all medical affairs that go on over there, then certainly I will make use of them.
There are safety fears too in Glasgow, where strict security surrounds Scotland's biggest Hogmanay party. 100,000 people applied for 15,000 tickets, and it's feared many may try to gatecrash this, the first event celebrating Glasgow's year as European City of Culture.
Morocco says it's facing environmental catastrophe from a giant oil slick off its coast. Ocean currents are pushing the slick towards rich fishing grounds off Safi. 27,000 tons of oil have poured from a stricken Iranian supertanker, HARLECH 5, since it caught fire 10 days ago. Environmentalists say it could cause more destruction than the Exxon Valdez spill in Alaska. Labour members of the Israeli government say they'll bring down the ruling coalition if a sacked cabinet minister isn't reinstated. Labour's Ezra Weitzman was dismissed by Likud Prime Minister Yitzhak Shamir for allegedly holding talks with the Palestine Liberation Organisation. New Year's celebrations are beginning a second later than usual this year because the Earth's been spinning too slowly. By international agreement, 1989 is to be extended, and an extra pip is being added to the Greenwich time signal.
It's in this small room in East Sussex that time is fixed. And this is the machine which makes the six pips heard on the hour by millions of radio listeners. But tonight, timekeeper Tony Seabrook will undertake a special task. By putting his finger on this spindle, he'll add an extra second to 1989. A new elongated pip will be added to the usual tone.
The Earth is slowing down relative to the very precise atomic clocks that we now use to generate time, which give us a constant second, which is very fine for engineers and physicists to use, but would mean if we kept to those, gradually you'd have midnight in the middle of the day.
In the long run, our year may have to be extended by hundreds of hours, but that's unlikely to happen for at least 350 million years. Lisa Hampley, ITN, the Royal Greenwich Observatory in East Sussex.
Finally, the weathermen have confirmed that 1989 has been the hottest year in Britain since records began 330 years ago.